You know, I'm going to make my wing removable on this, and I'm going to actually experiment with different wings. This is my Cessna Centurion. I've already broke the wing off. Every single time, it's been from catching it by hand. So I'm going to make this removable, and I'm using my X-Acto knife right now, and this is going to come right up. There we go. Okay. I'm going to put the two dowel rods in here and rubber band. I can put any kind of wing I want on here. I'm going to have to smooth this up a bit though. Okay, I've cut some copper wire to about 3/8 of an inch on both sides of the fuselage. I'm going to push it through the side of the foam now and put a drop of glue on it, and that will take care of having a place to use rubber band mount wing. Okay, a little foam safe super glue in all the strategic corners, and then hit it with the kicker so it dries instantly. And now we've got a place to put our wing on with rubber bands. So I have an assortment of rubber bands. And what I want to do is pick a couple that actually will fit just between the first and second copper, not too tight. And let's go ahead and put on the stock blade to start with, just to show you how that will work with these rubber bands. So all you need to do is to take the fuselage and hold the wing on where it's supposed to be with your thumb lightly. Put on the rubber band on the back part, bring it up to the front, and snap that on. Do the same with this side. Just like that, that's snapped on. Now the wing is on. So there you go, folks. Real easy to put any kind of wing that you want. Okay, as you see, I've taken a piece of foam. Actually, it's a spare from a wing that I had. I had some extra parts in here, and these were spare wing for the light stick here. And actually, I've also got an elevator right there. It looks like that would make a really great wing if I cut that out. Okay, we have a little problem with the servo here inside the Cessna Centurion. Now, I know it's pretty hard. You probably won't be able to see this down in here. But there's, on the end of the shaft, it's driven by the gear, there's this little white keeper right there. It had slid off. It was very difficult to get that back on there. Don't know if you can see it or not, but I put that back on. Just a little white keeper right there. You can see it. If it falls off, it just snaps onto the end of the thing. Your servo will not move, and it'll make all kinds of noise as you hear the motor run. So I've put that back together, and now we should have no trouble. Let's go ahead and try it. Okay, taking the elevator of that model airplane kit, and I have put that on the Cessna now. It's flat wing. Let's go see if it'll fly. Okay, I've cut the wing here. And I'm going to give this some dihedral now. I cut a slot out, so I'm going to hold this up, give it a little dihedral, hit it with the accelerator, the super glue, give that a second to dry. Dihedral helps model airplanes fly that only use rudder to turn. They're a lot more stable.